Is a special day for me. It's my birthday tomorrow, 33rd year in this world. And I want to preempt this, okay, if you'll hear me out. I know everyone was wanting to send all these presents and gifts and things, but here's the thing, don't do it. Do not do it. Instead, whatever you were going to buy and send, just use that money and put it on the campaign. It's time to be serious as we grow up. It's time to take this campaign seriously and our 33rd year of life. And I just want to say, we are overjoyed with the amount of people, it's almost 100 backers, who are loving this and blessing this and standing with God's will for the restoration of Israel. Happy birthday to me. My point is that I would like to take a minute and actually talk a little bit about my own Aliyah story, and it's a crazy one. As you hear, I speak English. You know, I came from, born in Oregon, lived in Ohio, lived in Canada, have many friends, maintain many relationships around the world. But eventually, we started reading these prophecies in Isaiah, Jeremiah, and one thing led to another, and we realized that, hey, we need to take up this ancient path of Aliyah and make it personal, and that's exactly what we did. But before we actually got the plane tickets, we were still undecided. We were like, well, we have our jobs. I was 15 at the time. We're a family of eight, you know, six kids. And this man comes in with his long white beard, long white hair. He says, you know, my name is Zebulun. That's, by the way, where we live, in the tribe of Zebulun area. But anyway, he's like, I want to support your return home. And I'd like to give you some American minted gold coins. He gave a satchel of gold coins to my dad. And that's how we made our return to this land. And after all eight of us made our aliyah to Israel, we lived happily ever after. Just kidding. It actually wasn't that easy. I don't want to scare you away, but literally having to learn a language, having to go to the army. I mean, we weren't army type at all. We had, you know, how do you get married here? Where's a community that you can come around you? Where will you live? And we kind of were a little nomadic here in the land, working in all kinds of different jobs. And essentially, I wish there was an Aliyah Return Center where we could have stayed in our first steps in this land, and it would have got us set up. It would have got our businesses set up. We would have found a proper apartment. I wish for an Aliyah Return Center. Oh, wait. One exists today, and you're helping make that possible. Thank you.
No more counting dollars, we'll be counting stars.
No, what's this? We'll be counting.